Today, I'm going to be speaking about how we can use our talents for God's glory and how we are commanded and required by the Lord to find out what our gifts are, our God-given gifts, and use them for the glory of God. So the passage that I'm going to be speaking from today is Matthew 25, verse 14 through 30. It's a long passage, so I'm not going to read it out, but it's basically about the parable of the talents, and I'm sure most of you have heard it. But basically the story is that a landowner is going away for a while, and he gives certain talents or amounts of money to some of his servants. He gives one of the servants 10 pieces of silver, the second one 5, and then the third one he gives them 2. And he goes away for a while, he comes back, and he asks, "What have you done with the money that I've given you?" And two of them made more money, and the third one did not make any. So that's basically the parable that we'll be going through today, and I want to go over 3 points. First, what does this parable mean and represent for us as a youth in the church? Second, how do we use our talents for the Lord? And third, what are the repercussions for not using our talents, and what is the reward for using the talents that God has given us? So first, let's go over what does this parable represent for us as children in the church. So this parable basically represents God the Father, giving each one of us certain gifts that we can use to build the church, to give glory to God, and to basically build the universal church in the world. So God gives us these gifts, and in our lives, he requires us to use them, to make more of them, and to basically multiply them, to use them, to develop them, and then to help the church as well. So that's what it means for us. Some of us are given different gifts, but we are all told not to complain about what we have been given, but accept what God has given us and then use that for his glory. So we as children, this is what we can get from this parable. This parable tells us we are those workers. God the Father is basically the landowner, and those talents, that money that was given to them, are the talents and gifts and the opportunities that have been given to us. And so secondly, let's move on to how do we use our talents for the Lord? So each of us are required and commanded by the Lord to use our talents for him. It's not a suggestion, it's not anything else. It's a command, it's a requirement that we as children, and we as youth, use our talents for the Lord, that we give ourselves, we use everything that we have been given for the glory of God. And we are told to basically find out and assess ourselves, to ask for God's guidance and to ask for counsel in order to know what our gifts are. And then we are told to help the church in those. And in 1 Corinthians 12, verse 12, Paul talks about the church of God being like a body and how every part of the body is a vital and important part for the whole body functioning. And he compares each of our body parts to different kinds of people in the church, and how each one of them is vital for the proper functioning of the church. And he talks about not complaining about what part or what role you have in the church. He compares it to an ear, saying if the ear does not want to be an ear, it cannot just stop being an ear, because then the body will not function properly. If the nose said, "I'm not an ear, so I do not want to be part of the body," then the body would not be able to function properly. So each of us, no matter how little you think your role could be, each of us have an important part to fill in the church. Just like your thumb. Like if a thumb is a small part of your body, but if you removed it, you would have a hard time picking everything up. Just like that, we may be young people, but that doesn't mean anything. God can still use us. God, in fact, uses young people all the time in the Bible. In the book of Genesis, God always was using younger people to lead his church, to lead Israel. God used Moses over Aaron. God used Joseph over all of his brothers. God used King David as the youngest of his brother. God chose Abel over Cain. God chose Jacob over Esau. So just because we are younger does not mean that God cannot use you, which means that we must be ready to use our talents, and we must be looking to develop our talents, and we must be praying to the Lord for guidance, for grace, so that we can find out what our calling is in the church and then use that. So, for example, You could be good at music. And if God has given you a gift with music, then you can use that to help in the worship. You can use that to uplift other people. If God gave you a gift of speaking, then you can use that to bring other people into the church. You can use that to encourage other people, other brothers and sisters you have in the church. If God maybe gave you the gift of organizing events and coordinating with people, then you can use that to help the church organize events, to bring more people into the church. The thing is, there's so many different gifts that God has given each one of us. Each one of us do have a gift. It's not that God hasn't given us anything. We all have something, and we are all required to basically obey the Lord in that command and give back whatever we possibly can. So that's number two. Number three was, what are the repercussions for not using our talents the way the Lord has commanded? And also, what are the rewards for using our talents as the Lord commanded? So we can see in Matthew 25, verse 24 to through 27, we see the example of that third servant in the parable who was given two talents, and the master comes back and he asks, "What did you do with those talents?" And that servant says, "I knew you were a harsh man, so I dug it up, and here are your two talents back." And the master's reply to that was, "Throw that worthless servant outside into the darkness where there would be weeping and gnashing of teeth." So what does that mean for us? It means that if we do not do the best with what God has given us, even if we're only given two talents, and if we do not do the best with what God has given us, we will be judged on the last day. So it's a reminding, it's a warning that this, what God has commanded us to do for the church, is not a suggestion, it's a command that we must do. And I'm working on it, we are all working on this, and we have to develop our talents and give it back to God, because if we do not, we're not going to hear those words, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." We're going to hear these words, "Throw that worthless servant into the darkness where there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth." And so it's important that the talents that God has given us, we use that for the Lord and not for ourselves. So if we're good at playing music, it's important that we use that to give glory to the Lord and not for ourselves. It's important that if we're good at speaking or we're good at singing, we use that to uplift the Lord's church and not only just to uplift ourselves and to make ourselves look better in the community. And not only do we use that outwardly in the church, but our hearts and our motives must be pure in doing that for the Lord. So if we were leading worship in the church, but we were doing it not out of a heart of worship for the Lord, but we were doing it out of a selfish motive, wanting to get all the praise and all the glory, that is not an acceptable offering to the Lord. That would count as not using your talents for the Lord. That would basically be like that third servant who didn't give back to the Lord, because although you were physically using them, you weren't doing them with a motive to worship the Lord, to give it back to the Lord. So everyone may see you doing something in the church, but if God sees that your heart was not in it and that your heart had selfish motives, then the Lord will not be pleased with that. And likewise, if we do minor things in the church that maybe people don't see all the time, but the Lord knows that we were doing that with a good heart, with a heart of service and a heart that wants to glorify the Lord, then that will be a blessing for us. The Lord will reward us on the last day. He will say, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." And that is the reward that God gives us on the last day. He lets us into his heaven, and because he's seen that we have done the best with what the Lord has given to us, that we have trusted in him for our salvation, and that we have worked to glorify his church, not with selfish motives, but with a motive to glorify the Lord and to uplift his church. And so the reward is coming to heaven to be received by the Lord, to be welcomed by him and welcomed by all the saints. That's the reward that we're looking for. And so God requires us now to work for him with a pure heart, and he will reward us. And so I wanted to go over these 3 points again. So first off, what does this parable represent? We know that it represents the Lord giving us talents that we are required to use. How do we use our talents for the Lord? We use our talents for the Lord by asking for counsel from our elders, asking for guidance, learning what our talents are, and then using them to help the church, to fill in needs that the church may have, and to use that so that his kingdom may grow in this world. And thirdly, we know the repercussions and the rewards for not doing and doing what the Lord has required us to do. We know the repercussions mean that the Lord will not receive us on the last day, that we will be judged on the last day. And we know that the reward is, if we do this, that the Lord will be receiving us on the last day, that we will have a place in heaven. So I pray that this word can apply to you. I'm working on doing this, and you're working on doing this. We're all working to develop our talents and do it for God's glory. So pray that this word blessed you, and thank you.
Thank you, Joshua, for the blessed message. May God bless you. And before we end the meeting, I just wanted to say what Youth Sunday means. And for me, it means that the youth come together to show their talents God has given to them. And participating in Youth Sunday does not only boost your confidence, but also helps you become closer with God. And when I started doing Youth Sunday, I was nervous. But when I look back, I see I got closer with God, and I am still getting closer with God. And the Bible says from Matthew chapter 19, verse 14,